or looked ahead to Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. Oftentimes, when you have that kind of pressure, hey, back to the booth, we got a caution.
Oh, and that's Ben Rhodes. Rhodes started at the back of the field today after they discovered a brake issue on that 41 truck. He was running 20th at the time, and Ben Rhodes, one of those drivers that was chase eligible, needing a win to get in. It's not going to happen today.
It looks like some pretty significant contact with the tire barrier there. See him moving around in that truck.
That truck was had some brake issues this morning in inspection. They fixed it, started in the back. Man, it's a tough road, Phil, when you start back there trying to work your way up through traffic, and he's buried that thing in there pretty far.
Boy, it really has. It doesn't even look like the front end's there anymore.
Well, watch him coming into the bottom of the frame here, and it's there you go.
He's going the wrong direction for sure. Yeah, I'd say it looked a lot like brake issues there again, don't you think?
Could have very well been.
It's his teammate, Hemric, that's going to try to get by on the outside.
Oh, and around goes the 29 of Reddick. It looked like maybe the 24 of Casgrella got into him a little bit.
All clear. Dig straight.
See Casgrella get back on the racetrack.
Timothy Peters, he's back in the 24th position with some transmission issues. You can see the 29 just get spun around there. I think Casgrella got into the back of him. Does a nice job of keeping the truck heading in the right direction after the contact.
There's Hemric trying to get by.
Reddick was running fourth at the time, and Grala was fifth.
Boy, does a really nice job doing a 360. Here's another view of it. You see the 19 of Hemric on the outside. Just a little bit of contact right there from Kaz Grala on the 24. Cendrick gets by as well with the two truck.
I believe Reddick was already in trouble before Kaz hit him. I think just on the inside he got
leads. But does he have enough gas to get to the end? The team says yes. When you look at where he last hit at lap 25, you don't know, but a big tangle. The 11 of Brett Moffitt and the 13 of Cameron Haley. Haley, one of those drivers that needed to win to make the chase, and there's a caution out on the track. So certainly, John Hunter Nemeche, if you want to save fuel, glad to see that caution, but it bunches up the field
again.
Yeah,
good and bad news for John Hunter Nemeche. He had over a two-second lead. He's going to be able to save a little bit more fuel, but he loses that lead.
This is a lot of caution laps he's been able to take advantage of, but golly, we didn't see anybody going 39 laps.
That's when you look at him pitting on lap 25, you think there's no way he's going to make it to the end. Lap 64. Crew chief says he can.
And they know how much he can save. They've tested that. They understand exactly how to coach John Hunter into saving as much fuel as he possibly can. Hope Cameron Haley doesn't need any fuel. It doesn't look like he's got anywhere to put it. His fuel pickup was set on the racetrack.
Tough break for the Canadian. Cameron Haley was hoping to come back and put it
Rico
in victory lane.
Well.
Hate to see that as Rico Abreu was running just outside the top 10.
Has a really solid day going.
Man, when someone else has problems and you're Timothy Peters running around with a transmission issue racing to be in the chase.
Well, Rico really got in and got the 13. Those are teammates.
Yeah, Gary Klute got a piece of that as well with a 51 truck. Take another view, look at top of your screen.
The 81 of Ryan Truex
slipped
got
by.
Some damage there as well.
Look at all the damage on the 81. This is a big crash, a lot of trucks involved.
There's a damage that the 51 got from getting into the 98 of Rico Abreu.
On board with Cameron Haley.
That was his teammate Rico that got into him and turned him around. He tried to get it going really quick, and he's going to get hit pretty hard here by the 11 of Brett Moffitt.
Remember, Phil, as they're racing up that.
Custer Strong on the outside. Contact.
A lot of it. And Casgrella goes around and gets into the wall. Caution is out.
Wow, what an aggressive run up the hill by our front row. It looked like Cole Custer was trying to pinch John Hunter down, and John Hunter wasn't having any of it. He ran him off the road. And then behind them, a spin and a great run by the youngster, Casgrella. It's going to come to an end.
So strong, ran in the top five for a good part of this race.
And just think about something we said earlier. Everybody that has a problem, that's good news for Timothy Peters. He's racing for the championship. He'll gain that spot.
Kaz Grala about fourth row there in the blue. You see him 24.
Looked like he and Matt Crafton got together a little bit. Kaz, I think, may have turned it right to avoid running into the 88 of Crafton.
Cameron Haley off course again.
What about
no play side of the track. Watch the 22 truck of Austin Wayne Self as he comes off turn 9. Get into the back end and into the tires. Looks like maybe he had a little bit of help.
Here's Tyler Reddick. He's going to try to get to his inside here. A little bit of contact. So that could have done something to that right rear tire and maybe caused that incident. Obviously right there, the right rear tire is down. So more than likely.
Nemechek right on the bumper of Cole Custer. Custer getting through. Here they come through turn 9. Nemechek gives him a little bump. Custer hanging on. Nemechek gets into it. John Hunter Nemechek and Cole Custer. They're rocking and spinning, coming to the line. Who is it going to be? Side by side through the grass.
I think it looked like Nemechek to me, but I'm not sure. Did Hemric get by both of them?
I'm not sure anybody knows who crossed the line first. Lead coming to the final turn, and John Hunter Nemechek moved him.
There was plenty of room down there on the racetrack inside of the double zero. He was right at the edge of the racetrack.
That's how they crossed the finish line side by side, going through the grass.
And this is the finish, but it's just the start of the disagreement between these two guys.
So there's the bump in turn 9 and through 9 and 10, and eventually Nemechek and Custer got into the grass.
Custer really,
and that's how they finished.
Really didn't have any racetrack to race on there at the end. He got pushed over in the grass.
In the 33, he's in.
Oh, William Byron into the outside wall.
Correct. Rear clip, stay up there. Five more.
Five-time winner this season, William Byron, our championship points leader coming into the race, was running 11th.
Just exactly what you were talking about, Michael, down on the inside of the 41 of Ben Rhodes and got loose.
This guy's won 5 races this year. He's a rookie, but he's done an amazing job. That's going to be something we're going to watch all night, Phil. These guys, especially when it gets down to crunch time, they get on the inside of other trucks. They're just really a handful, and you can see one of the best out there hard into the outside wall.
Heavy damage to that Kyle Busch Motorsports machine, and William Byron, the 18-year-old rookie, takes it. Here's why we're under caution for the second time tonight. It's the 9 truck of William Byron into the wall. They repaired the truck 40 laps off track and then repaired it and brought him back out. And then you'll see him on board here, the 29 of Reddick. So Byron into the wall.
Well, guys, we're hearing that the double zero was speeding on pit road. We'll have to serve a penalty, go to the back of the tail end for speeding on pit road.
Too late to make a mistake now.
Oh, wow.
Need to go where we will turn it off.
And now we've got a caution. Contact. That's the 71 sliding through the infield. That's Josh Berry.
Josh had done a nice job, Phil. Ray Romano on the
leaders in the middle of 3 and 4.
There you see the 71. Not sure what started that, but did come through the grass, and as you said, fortunate no contact. Doesn't look to be any significant damage. With the 4 fresh tires, the 33 of Kennedy and the 51 of Suarez took fuel only on that last stop, and they're no match for the 18. Kyle Busch to the lead.
Oh,
and a spinner. Kennedy got contact from the 21 of Sauber.
Stay with it. Stay with it.
Big crash.
Stay with it. All right, guys, we're wrecked here. Hang on, Ben. It's still coming. Hold the steering wheel tight. Hold tight.
Ben Kennedy already locked into the chase. Fortunately, because his truck has heavy damage.
Got us there, Abby.
Yeah, contact from his teammate, Johnny Sauter. Certainly wasn't intentional, I'm sure.
Wow, but that's a tough break there to get hit in the back by your teammate.
Look at all the damage to Matt Crafton's Toyota.
See where it happens here. There's Sauter, the 21.
I think Johnny just gets a little bit loose and moves up just a little bit, just a slight bit. You can barely see a mark on the side of that 33 truck. Ben does a great job. If he didn't have any other vehicles, he probably would have been okay, would have saved it. Ben Rhodes came along with nowhere to go, make contact, turn him around. You see the damage that Crafton got. And how about Reddick just barely getting by?
Yeah, a couple of chase contenders, John West Townley and also the 23 of Spencer Gallagher also narrowly escaped.
Yeah, Townley has to just take evasive actions to the bottom. You can see nails the gas, keeps it low, and drives barely past Ben Kennedy. And then Ben Rhodes turns Kennedy back up into the track, and a great job by the 29 truck of Tyler Reddick as well.
Boy, several championship chase contenders narrowly missed being involved in this one. One of those that was hoping to maybe pull out a win and earn a chase spot tonight, Ben Rhodes in that 41.
There's your nose
panel. He took some contact, yeah. On board with Cole Custer here in the double zero.
Rhodes have back coming. He's wrecking ahead, middle, high.
Whoa.
All good. All right, you're good, south.
Barely by. Watch out, Reddick
misses this. Back it down. Come on. Back it up. Come on.
An amazing job. Amazing job by Tyler Reddick.
Look at that contact there that spins Kennedy. And then these guys are running 170 miles an hour, guys. And you don't just turn these things on an instant going that fast. You can see
Ben Rhodes was as low as he could go given the speed he had. He couldn't just drive down to the flat.
Watch Reddick there. Wow.
Turn that thing hard. You could see his hands on the steering wheel. Turn that truck hard left to avoid that 33.
Might have even taken a little bit of contact
on that right side.
Yeah. Now the 33 of Ben Kennedy, that truck is just destroyed. And
it was so fast too, Vince, and we're racing toward
it. Sauter right there in third, and John West Townley fourth. Spencer Gallagher and Custer get into it, and there's Infinger getting the end result.
Big damage for the double zero of Cole Custer.
Hey, Get roll.
Custer's truck is smoking from a tire rub.
Unfortunate for Custer.
23.
Yeah, he loses his nose. That's the aero dependency that he loses. And then Custer makes a move to the inside, and Infinger was there. Great heads-up drive by Custer not to run over the top of Gallagher, but unfortunately, Grant Infinger was right there racing with him.
So again, that could have been a lot bigger than it actually was, but definitely Gallagher going to get a little bit of damage on that right rear. Custer got some damage, and of course Infinger going through the infield.
And just watch this race heat up. This is why these ends of these races are so exciting, because they just have to go right now.
That was an amazing move.
Back it down.
Amazing move by Cole to avoid Spencer Gallagher.
Left corner right there.
Because you can see Cole was pushing too. His truck wasn't handling in that big pack. But he's able to somehow wrestle it to the inside of Gallagher. Like you said, Phil, just an amazing job.
Look how sideways that 24 truck of Grant Infinger is. And he actually never spun all the way around. He ended up straightening that truck back out. He's past 90 degrees right now.
Side by side with his teammate.
That's for 9th and 10th. Caution is out, the 44 of Tommy Joe Martins.
That's a shame. Tommy Joe was running in the 14th position. Somebody wrecked him. I think he said Suarez just wrecked us.
Heavy damage there on the 44. Martins was right there at 14th and Suarez 15th, right in that area. So those two drivers running near one another, and heavy damage for the 44.
Yeah, top 15 would have been a great effort for this team here.
You could see maybe Suarez gets loose on the inside of the 44, pushes him up the track.
A lot of damage to Tommy Joe Martin's truck.
That's a solid run for that team too. It's a shame have it taken away inside 20 to go. The outside.
Six laps to go. Oh! Reddick gets into the back end of John West Townley, and Townley is into the wall. Caution is out.
Lock it down there, bud. Lock it down.
And John West Townley's chase hopes come to an end.
Really hard.
Got to your quarter panel, bud. Just nudged you.
Really hard racing with Tyler Reddick.
It'd be interesting to.
29.
It's got to be a hard place to spot, Phil. You know, the spotter's on the roof, the truck's right there on the inside. They were battling for the fourth position. Look at the damage on the 29. Truck.
See, he was trying to work him on the outside, as Michael was talking about. I think John West thought he was clear and went to move up to the racetrack to get his entrance into turn one right. And at this late stages of the race, Reddick wasn't going to back off.
No, you can see John West had him run way up the track. Nothing wrong with that. But don't expect the 29 truck of Reddick to let off the gas. We're past that stage of the race. Watch this. Wow.
Rico Abreu, by the way, gets the free pass on board here with the 29.
I hear you, man. Keep coming. He's an idiot. Keep coming there, man. Good job. BP4, Thompson's out.
Yeah, there wasn't even time for Reddick to get out of the gas.
Reckon,
when they
Reckon, made down, contact. Down, down. Once you come back, all good. Caution is out.
Yeah, if he backs out of the gas, Phil, he might get caught up into that wreck. He had to just keep pushing and keep going.
Caught out the yellow. Got an eye on that 98. Here he comes as Self had gotten into some contact and then came back down the track and got into the right front of Abreu.
Looked like at one point Rico had a truck they might could win this race with, and to end it like that. Nine truck, the Liberty University, whoa, Toyota goes underneath a spinning truck.
That's a 74 truck.
Timothy Vaines has gotten himself in a bind here. That'll bring out the red. But that's a big break for Byron. He puts that lap up. He's the fastest truck. He can pull in the pits, sit there, let the tires cool off somewhat. That truck will be primed to break the track record in the next round.
Yeah, and had that spin happen when William was over in 3 and 4 before he completed that lap, they would have thrown the red, and that would have negated that lap, even though already.
Boy, it didn't take long for that, did it? First one of the day, and it's the 10 of Caleb Rourke. And in against that, the security of the sand barrels right there at the front entrance of pit road.
Yeah, obviously had some sort of an issue there. The right front was locked up.
Looked like he tried to get onto pit road, and the right front of that truck was dragging the ground. You can see the sparks there, and it just wouldn't turn.
Second lane was banked a little bit more than the bottom. Oh, trouble already.
Big contact in the back, the 49. That's Josh Wise and the 63 of Okonori Ogata.
63 cut up on you there, bud.
So heavy damage to that truck and the 49 of Josh Wise.
He gets loose off of two there. He's probably going to just drive down into the 49 of Josh Wise. And nothing Josh could do about it. He's minding his own business, and the 63 just got loose.
That had to just shock Josh Weiss. I bet he was stunned when those trucks came together. He was pointed straight down the back straightaway, and all of a sudden, he's just head on into the outside wall.
There's another view of it there from behind. And as you mentioned, there's no way Josh had any idea that that was coming.
You're fortunate that those trucks behind those two didn't end up getting caught up in that wreckage as well. Looks like everybody else avoided contact. But certainly the 63 and 49 with heavy damage.
23 truck.
And there's a problem for Daniel Hemric, one of our chasers.
I think the left front tire is down on that truck.
Spun around, had a flat tire, and looks like couldn't quite keep control of it. He was fading back, running in the 12th position. This caution, though, could keep him on the lead lap.
Wall contact at all, was able to keep it off the concrete, but certainly a tough start to the race for one of our championship chasers, Daniel Hemric.
A lot of times, Phil, on short tracks, you get to racing side by side, and someone will bounce into your left side, maybe trying to get underneath of you and knock a valve stem out.
Good.
John Hunter Nemechek, another one of our chase contenders with a problem.
All right, one more. All right, go if you can. Go, 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 go.
Nemechek was running 13.
Sound the alarm. Issues.
Trying to pass another truck. We're hearing it might have been the 24 of Kaz Grala. There he is, already spinning. He was trying to get by that 24 blue truck of Kaz Grala. Let's ride along with John Hunter. See what we can see from this spin here.
07, coming slow on the side. Exit 2, outside 24.
Just drove in there really hard and couldn't get the truck.
Spawn here, 2, spawn here, 2.
couldn't get it turned well enough to keep the back end under.
Others during that pit stop took on two tires and gained track position, and there's the double zero of Cole Custer going around to bring out the yellow.
Get ready to put more tires on.
Is that a little bit of damage to the left front, Phil?
Kind of looked like it for a moment. He was running in the 16. Same situation as John Hunter Nemechek. He got loose underneath another truck trying to make the pass. Here's see him it. Right there trying to make the pass. Oh. On. That's Johnny Sauter, the 21 truck.
And you can see that truck just bobble, and then it was out of control. Let's ride along with John Hunter Nemechek and watch what happens.
Inside tight, spin middle, yellow is out.
Amazing job by those guys around him, not making any contact.
And it was a real, got a spin by the 16 of Friesen. I think that was a real important moment for the young man. William Friesen was on the lead lap in the 18th position, doing a nice job in that 16 truck.
Looked like he was down on the bottom trying to get by a lap truck and just lost a little bit of grip.
Austin Wayne Self into the wall. Going to bring out the caution. Heavy damage to the right side of that truck.
Right in the wall.
Well, Self was running 19th just inside the top 20. And that, as you said, Phil, going to set up another restart and give somebody else maybe an opportunity.
Oh. They sure spun around quick. And it didn't look like he'd gone in a corner any harder than that other truck that he had caught.
Heavy contact.
Yeah, look at the smoke. See the fluid on the outside of the racetrack. Nothing Austin Wayne Self could do.
Indicating a missed shift.
Caution on the track in the 49 of Tommy Joe Martin's, Wayne Edwards with a problem. He's gotten into the wall there in the right front because of a problem for the 49 of Wayne Edwards.
Wayne just got a little bit loose there and had to use a little bit more racetrack.